Hey guys, I'm back with another tutorial. This is more of a definitely going out on the town type of look. Would not recommend this on a daily basis or going to work. In an office. Other types of work, maybe it's okay. Anyway, this is using all L'Oreal products, L'Oreal Infallible Line, which is their new eyeshadows. Now, they were provided to me by the company. I was sent an email and asked if I'd like to participate in a contest which was open to all Canadian bloggers to create a look for the L'Oreal Paris Bold Eye Look. So of course I said yes, I jumped at the chance to try new products. I used the products for about 2 to 3 weeks before I've done this video and I love them. The wear time is great, it's totally wearable, blendable, lasts a long time, and the pigment and the shimmer is unbelievable. I have never had a product this shimmery with this much pigment. It's usually pigment or sparkles and shimmer, and this one has it both all, which is great. You can check in the full disclosure down in the bottom button, and you can also check my blog for a full list of products that were provided to me, because not everyone that I show in this video was given to me. I did purchase some of my own in order to make this video, so please know that. Basically, I need you guys to rate, subscribe, and comment on my video if you like it. Please do let me know, I love hearing about it. And I guess that's pretty much it. So stay tuned to see how to get this hard look. Okay guys, as you see, I've already had one eye done, and this eye I've already primed my eye, so we're gonna go right into the eyeshadows. The brushes I'm using are all e.l.f., so they're very easily accessible for you guys. So the first color I'm taking is Hourglass Beige from the collection. So we're going to apply this right from your lash line right up to your eyebrow. If you see a little blue tint, that's because I didn't clean my brush off good enough. So always work from lightest to darkest when you're doing these kinds of eye looks, because if not, you get this. But it's not going to affect the look at all. Then we're taking Time Resist White. And what we're doing with this one is we're hitting our inner corner of our eye and just down below the bottom lash line. And when you hit the inner corner, just go a little bit into where that little nook is in your eye, because you definitely want that to be as light as you can so you don't kind of look like you have dark under circles. So hit that area and then just hit right underneath your eyebrow. Next comes the Daring color, and it is so close to like what my earrings color is. It's amazing. This is All Night Blue, which is a gorgeous, gorgeous shade. So with that, we're taking the same brush and we're going to just put it on your lid. And then I'm just taking the tip of the brush and I'm just kind of feeling my crease and just kind of making that line. And then I'm not going really any farther than like the bulb of my eyebrow. I'm just kind of keeping it right there, and I'm keeping the inside of that eye nice and light. And then I'm just going to take it and kind of sweep it just to blend that out. Next we're going to take Unlimited Sky, which is just like a really kind of rich sky blue. The same contour brush. Just feathering the edges of that dark blue so this blends into the rest of the lid space or your eye area without having a different tonal completely. And it just gives it a little different dimension with the different color sparkles, which is nice. Then I'm going to take an angle brush and the All Night Blue shade again. And I'm just going to run it along the lash line, and this is a damp brush. Then we're going to go around our tear duct with this. And you just want a nice straight line. You don't want to go into the white a whole lot, because you want your inside of your eye to look white. Or look light. If you have that, we're going to take our small precision brush. And we're going to mix the two blues, the Unlimited Sky and the All Night Blue. I'm just going to smudge it. but next I'm taking the L'Oreal Paris Carbon Black Intense Liner with the felt tip, which is the same as the Earth and Rock brown that I always use. Now we're not doing any kind of cat liner. We're just going to intensify our lash line. So we're just doing a super thin, as close to the lash line as you can get, black, just to help to define the lash area from the color. Now I'm not done putting color on the lid, but I'd like this to blend in a little bit more. So if any color kind of falls on it, that's even better. You get the look more. And the same thing with the bottom. We're just taking any kind of black Kohl eyeliner. I'm going to smudge that right into the lash line. And we're going to go around the inner duct. And then you're going to line your inner rim. You especially want to get this little inner corner. Because that's what's kind of going to help you get a nice, smoky, very defined cat eye look without doing the cat liner and big wings. Taking your precision brush or your angled brush, just going to smudge that out. See the difference that that made? Next, to make it look a little bit more like peacocky with a little more tones, we're going to take the Burning Black, which is not black at all. It's a gorgeous deep purple burgundy tone. It's unbelievable. Take our contour brush and we're just gonna hit kind of the first third of your eye with this. And it's gonna be a nice subtle shade, but it just makes your eye a little more interesting than having it one color. And then we're just going to be very carefully going down into your lids, your inner corner a little bit. It's still keeping that time-resist white there and intact. Okay, to keep going, we're going to use the Permanent Khaki, which is an awesome khaki green. I say it's a little, it's like of the deeper khaki colors, more army. I guess it's khaki too. And we're gonna put this right above, like right underneath your arc. So kind of above, off to the side of your eye, your pupil. And these colors, just with the blue, just help to give a little more interest to the plain blue color, but it's definitely blue that you see, but what makes it a little bit more interesting and different when it catches the light are those different shades of sparkle from the colors. Next, we're just going to deepen the outer corner of your eye a little bit, and we're going to go with the Eternal Black, which is a gorgeous black sparkle. It's pigmented and it's sparkly, which is hard to get both. Taking your contour brush again, so you don't need too many brushes for this look. And you're just going to honestly dab it. And then just do little, I'm just doing little circles. Bringing it out a little bit from underneath on an angle, and I'm just darkening that up. See, and I'm okay that that's covering your liner. That's fine. The only reason you put that liner on was to make your eyelashes look thicker. That's it. So now that you have that corner darkened and it's everything's looking even, and I'm going back and just touching up some areas on this eye. So once you have your two eyes touched up, it shouldn't be a problem for you because you're doing both at the same time. But when you do them separately, this is when you get a different heavy-handedness in certain areas. Anyway, so you have that done. So next, just curl your lashes. And I'm applying the L'Oreal Double Extend Mascara with the Lash Boosting Serum. This stuff is my favorite. I'll probably apply 3 to 4 coats of this. Okay guys, so for blush, I've just put a nice soft natural blush on my cheeks because it's obviously your eyes are the focus here, so let's not do anything too drastic with the cheeks. You can throw on some bronzer if you want, whatever you want, just nothing too harsh. Now for a highlight, this is what I like about these eyeshadows. You can use the lighter colors for a highlight. This is Forever Pink and I love the name for starters. I'm just taking a fan brush And I'm just hitting the tops of my cheekbones. Because I like... And then just putting it on my cheeks. I like a pinker hue to my highlight. Now, if you want something a little bit more golden toned, you can use the Hourglass Beige, which was the first shadow we used. And honestly, they're all great. You just give... And that way you just get a nice natural glow on your cheeks, and you've used it in your eyeshadows as one less thing you need to take with you, which is awesome. Now for lips, I'm going to take the same brush I use for smudging. It's a small precision e.l.f. brush. Obviously clean it off first. And I'm using the Time Resist White, which we use on our inner corners. Now I'm just going to trace out my Cupid's bow and just a little bit up. And then just a little bit down the sides. And just take my finger and kind of blend that out. And that's going to give the illusion of slightly bigger lips when you put on your lip gloss, which is great. And it will last you a long time. A very, very long time. And for lips, I'm going with another neutral tone. This is the L'Oreal Infallible Never Fail Lip Gloss 6 Hour in Modern Mauve. And one thing I like about it is really the applicator. It has a nice point, so you can really trace out your lip line. And this lip gloss does last for a very long time. I definitely made it through 3/4 of the day at work with drinking and eating and talking and things like that, which is great. It does have the tendency, it can go on your teeth very easily, I've noticed, because my fiance told me a couple times when I was attending a wedding, you have some stuff that's kind of on your teeth there. And I was like, oh my god, really? So to avoid having any lipstick on your teeth, just take your finger, wrap your lips around it, and any of the lip gloss that was on the inside of your mouth that could go onto your lip is on your finger and hopefully not on your teeth, because the Never Fail stuff will stick. So guys, this is my final look for the L'Oreal contest. So I really hope you guys like it. It's a really nice, fun look. Great, as I said before, kind of like a peacock inspired. Just like my earrings for the fall with great jewel tones. And they are great products. I really do like them. So thanks for watching, guys. And don't forget to check my blog.